What is good, guys? We are here with the deciding World Cup game between India and US Metro. And Obi decided to bring this team. I think Amy used this earlier too. This kind of looking like this kind of deja vu for me, because Amy's opponent also had a team with a type of Bulu and a Heat Shun. So yeah, you guys will probably remember the sets. I went over all the sets earlier, but he's Ghost of Chang is there, which is probably the safest play overall. If Greninja had spikes, I would have gone for spikes there, but probably has U-turn or Ice Beam in the last slot. He's confirmed Ash Greninja, and yeah, Tangles can go for knockoff. He did earthquake putting the Heatran. Tapu Bulu was a good play there, because it covered the knockoff play, it covers the earthquake play. And Tangles doesn't really run Sludge Bomb anymore at the moment. So yeah, he can go into Majorna here. But yeah, we had the same scenario earlier with Pokémon where the Tapu Bulu was in. Where like, it's kind of hard to go hard into Majorna, because like, you are offensive Majorna on this team, I think, yeah, and it would just take a lot from plus 2, or just in general, from a Z-move. The Bulu was for Z-move there. So looking at Blind Mix's team, is that, I think my man BTB made this team. I think it might be Subtoxic Heatran. It's always Majorna, Z-move, Tapu Bulu, Starfox, Landro, and then Scarflady, Specs, Gren is what I think. I just want to make sure that I'm recording the correct game, but this should be the correct game, right? I thought he would go for Z-move there, but he does go for Hornleech. Maybe predicting a switch, but I mean that works out fine for him, because he just got health back, so that worked out, and he weakened the Tangrowth. And he didn't have to waste a Z-move, so that's cool for Blimax. This type of Bulu is looking like it's gonna pick up a kill here, because he doesn't have a Hornleech resist that he can switch in. Like, Majorna can switch in, yeah, but it's gonna take a lot, and it's gonna get blown away by Z-move on the next turn. If it doesn't get Tuit killed by the stab grass move, which it probably will, it would probably avoid the Tuit kill from a grass stab, but because it's still a Majorna, even if it's offensive, yeah, it has good bulk. So this is tough for OB. Like, it's not like he has a switch, and he kind of has to pick what he wants to sag here. So he decides to sack the Mew, as he can barely live that. I can see the Mew outspeeding this for sure, because the Papa Bulu is going to be probably adamant to break like fat cores on the other side. Break walls. Papa Bulu hits 273. Okay, I don't. That's if it's Jolly. Okay, yeah, never mind then. Adamant hits. Okay, I'm in the wrong calculator. I was in the ADV calculator for the other gen that was earlier. I'm pretty sure the Mew outspeeds it, but it still didn't make the move. So if Mew runs 56 speed, which some Mews run more speed, yeah, the Mew outspeeds it definitely if it's Adamant Bulu. So Blimax might want to go on a Heatran here. So this is Rock's Mew, we all know this from the team. I've seen his team in action, and it's the only potential rocker. So I can see him going for Rocks Break in the Heatran here, as he does just play it safe. I mean, it's understandable that you want to play safe in that scenario, because if the Bulu stays in, it's going to be really bad. But I mean, on one side, the Heatran there was kind of obvious, but on the other side, it's also kind of super risky to like play around with a plus 2 type of Bulu, as it might be Scarf Heatran. It might be Scarf Heatran. And yes, Bandit Zyga takes it decently well, considering it was a Flash Fire boosted Fire Blast. And yeah, he's just gonna go for Toxic or Iron Tail here, I think. I probably would go for Toxic. Because Iron Tail would cover the Bulu, but Toxic also covers the Landorus. Like, Toxic covers these two. Even though Bulu coming in would be really annoying. So Iron Tail is definitely an option here. You can also Double Switch. Double Switch is another option. Wow. So he did Fire Blast Burning, which sucks a lot. But yeah, Obi did predict. Yeah, that's what I was thinking. Like, he could have Double Switched there. So that was a really aggressive play on Blimey's side. But the chat is just going wild. They're saying Golden anything. Like, Finch, why did he Toxic? I mean, I can understand why he would Toxic. Like, it covers the Bulu and the Lando. I might have Toxic too in that scenario. But yeah, he hits all his Fire Blast, and this was locked into Toxic anyway, so even if you missed that one. The burn didn't really matter, I think. I mean, the Zygarde, he still could have saved the Zygarde, but it's not like he had good Fire Blast switch-ins. And yeah, he's... Okay, so I got this wrong. Did I get it wrong? Yeah, I think I said it's AV Majuna. I mixed up the teams. On this team it's Offensive Majuna, on this team it's... I think it's AV, because that's Specs Hydro Pump. Just want to make sure that I don't say anything wrong, but I'm pretty sure that should be... Specs Hydro Pump, as the Majuna is gonna... Yeah, the Majuna gets a free Volt Switch here, basically. Like, he doesn't have a Ground Up or anything like that. So he can just keep up momentum that way. And it's looking really good for Team India all of a sudden. Or, like, not all of a sudden, but, like... I didn't expect this, good lord. Ginger, Majuna, Assault Vest, Hydro Pump, there's Life Orb, Chest Packs, does 37 to 44 and did 38, so yeah, that was like a lower roll. I mean, that's the standard Majuna spread. Some Majunas run more Speed Death, so he could definitely be running more Speed Death. I know there's an ABR spread that runs a lot of Speed Death to like switch better into Specs Gengar. But yeah, I assume he's gonna basically sack off the Mew here. Like, the Mew will lift his Volt Switch. But whatever comes in will basically pick off the Mew. I mean, he can still save it. Let's say the Greninja comes in, he can still go into Tangrowth. Say the Greninja does come in. So if he has U-turn, he can go for U-turn here. If it kills the Mew, obviously, like, I would still run the Kulk. If it's Fist of Mew, U-turn might not kill. So we can run the Kulk here, but... I'm thinking... Okay, let me look at his team. Okay, Hydro Pump there, which is a weird play. I mean, he predicted the Majuna, but... I think Dark Pulse was fine there. Like, either U-turn or Dark Pulse. And if you don't have U-turn... Like, if you didn't have U-turn there, I would have Dark Pulsed. Or I would have Spiked if I had Spikes, but... I don't think he has Spikes. Let me think. He could technically still have Spikes, because... He's gonna be a Scarf Defog Lardy most likely. What did I say? Never mind. We already know that he's Scarf Heatran, so the Lardy's is gonna be like Soul Dual Specs, yeah. Good lord. So yeah, Lardy's is like kind of a reliable defogger, quote unquote, because Bantar is not that common on Tita at the moment. I mean, it's kind of common, but like he does go for the Zemo. When it's blown, the Zemo's gonna be blown away. Yeah, I was kind of irritated for a second because I was like trying to fix my error there because I said it could be Scarf Lardy. It's obviously Scarf Trend's already revealed, like just from the way it outsped the Zygarde, from the damage it did. Definitely Offensive Trend, like Fire Blast is more mainly seen on Scarf Trend. But yeah, it's looking really good for Team India. I don't see how Obi can bring it back. He has his Shift Game Majuna. But I don't think Shift Game Majuna can. like the combination of AV Majuna is gonna be able to take a hit. He also has Water Shuriken priority. And after he waits to Z focus blast, he also has to hit a focus blast on Heatran to kill that. But yeah, Z, Shifty and Jenna are still a threat. You don't have to, like, we cannot sleep on that. Like, that can potentially still turn it around. Good lord, the chat is going so wild. But the game is not over until it's over. The score is 4-4, if I didn't mention it yet. So whoever wins this is in World Cup. Like, either India or US Metro. But I think in the last game, India basically had it in ADV, but I think they threw the game away then, but I didn't see that game. I only saw a few turns. So I don't really know much about ADV, so I didn't record it. Okay, let's see. Yeah, I think his only play is basically Midjourney, yeah. And then he has to shift gear. Okay, he goes on the Latios. Which is interesting. I mean, this doesn't have... This doesn't get Plera for anything to touch Lati other than like... Z Stonehenge, Z Superpower, but he already showed Z Bloom Bloom. So maybe he's going for the win with a... No, he's Scarf Lati, what am I saying? Like, I was trying to think maybe he would be Common Lati if he changed the team. But I'm pretty sure he's just Scarf. What is he gonna go for? Psychic? Psyshock? That is absolutely nothing. Yeah, I don't see how he can win. Landorus... I don't know if I would have gone Landorus there. Not letting the Midjourney take damage is definitely a play I agree with, because that is important to check the opposing Midjourney. He throws up the rocks, which is definitely nice. But yeah, I'm realizing I can't concentrate 100% because I'm really exhausted and tired. And yeah, I will definitely go sleep after this. I did get some sleep earlier, like, it's not that I didn't sleep at all, but it could have been a bit more sleep, let's put it that way. Yeah, we will get the teams later. And we might get the matchups like later or tomorrow for like the main rounds of World Cup, or like however you say that, the main round, the main tournament. But Aggressive are in this end, and SD is definitely an option because Tang is only just 30%, like 37. I mean, can do a little bit more or less with a roll, but like, basically doesn't do enough. I can also see him going into Heatran here on the HP Ice, and then go back into Tapu Bulu to get the grass terrain back. Not that he needs it, but okay, go in the Latios on the Earthquake. Good lord, the chat is gonna go wild because they're gonna say, how does he do it? Okay, so now we will see if he's a choice back Slady. It would be interesting to see if he can kill this Tangrowth. I don't think he will ever go hard in the Midjourney because that's like the late game win con for Obi. Latios. Life Orb would do, Draco would do 49 to 58. Okay, so even Specs wouldn't kill. Goes back in the top, Bulu predicting the knockoff. Yeah, that's, see, that's like the, basically the play that I said, but instead of Heatran, he went into Latios. So, OP actually predicted him to potentially make that Heatran pivot. So, that was nice on Blimex not making that Heatran play. Not, like, not risking the Heatran Earthquake. I'm not really sure why you unleashed there. But it potentially predicted a hard Latios and just wanted some damage. But he's basically willing to sack off his Tapu Bulu here, is what I get from this SD play. Just to get... I mean, he can only cheat to get health back, that's another option, yeah. Yeah, he can only cheat. And he will get health back enough to live another hidden power. And yeah, only cheat doesn't kill, but... Wood Hammer kills, wow. So yeah, that explains the Z Wood... Like, Z Bloom is a fucking nuke. Like, Z Woodhammer is so crazy. Like, ZardX, I think 4 times resisted it, but that's, like, I've seen it, a crit do like 60% to ZardX or 66 from Z Bloom, and it was 4 times resisted. I know it's Grass Turn boosted and Bulu is strong, but still. But yeah, Greninja comes out here and... Magearna can't switch it anymore. Protect is really clutch here. To make sure that he doesn't... what he locks himself into. And this gives you a free Latios because you know he's locked in the Hydro Pump. Yeah. I mean, Obi could have potentially doubled into Magearna there. But, like I said, I don't even know if the Magearna can somehow pull it through. Because I think if Blamix plays it correct, he has this 100%. Yeah. But yeah, like I said, not over until it's completely, actually over. Oh, 256 users, good lord. There's also DBP finals going on, but you're not gonna record that. Not a DBP expert. I mean, I recorded one DBP game earlier, but only because it was for World Cup. And yeah, I guess if I would get some expert guests, I might do some more DBP in the future. Yeah, he did predict the double switch. He did predict the double switch. I was about to say, you probably just go for Draco there. And he does dodge the Draco. Which sucks, because now the Latios is in range of Hydro Pump, and he doesn't have a good switch in. Like, Greninja is his only resist, but Greninja would probably get 2-hit KO'd. Let's calc that real quick. It's so annoying to always put in Greninja and then put a choice specs over life, or if it's not in the ash form yet, because the calculator doesn't have that. If he doubles, gives him his own Latios. On a hidden power fire. So Blamix there potentially predicting the Magearna. I think Blamix can afford to sack his Latios because it loses to everything. And he can see that way he can see what Obi locks himself into. So yeah, if Obi went for defog there, could have picked off the Latios, and I didn't really see the point for Obi to keep this. And now Greninja gets a free switch. I mean, Landorus also gets a free U-turn if he wants that. Because Psyshock won't do that much. We have seen it earlier. It basically bounced off. But he does decide to go to Greninja. But yeah, I can definitely see the difference when I like near it again and when I come in from team preview and have time to analyze and I got my sleep. It's definitely a better narration. But now it's just that I'm getting a little tired. He knows the Latios locked into Psyshock, so Hydro Pump is definitely a fine play. Definitely better than Dark Pulse with the Magearna in the back. Because you don't want that thing. You don't want that Magearna putting you down. Like, the Magearna can revenge sweep you if you go for Dark Pulse. Also, Hydro Pump can still miss on the Magearna, so... we'll see what happens here. I hope you don't see some hacksy end game that will cost India the World Cup. Participation, or however you say that. Good lord, I should not try to play around. Oh, I disconnected. No, not like this. Don't do... okay, he didn't get a crit, which doesn't matter. Like, you guys saw, Obi was just willing to sack the Lati. He didn't have a good switch in. And yeah, he gets off the Ash from now. The Magearna is basically gonna have to dodge this. Oh my god, why did I disconnect during this last deciding turn, or last deciding turns? Yeah, I was behind there, so what happened? He switched out into Landorus on the shift gear. So I don't know if I would have switched out. Because this is Ice Beam and your Landorus is gonna get blown away now. Wait, what happened? He disconnected. I was about to say, what does it say, joint battle? Is it my internet that died? Dude, it's like my internet, we both got DS'd at the same time. Like, I disconnected and then I come back and this guy's also disconnected. Okay, he's back. Chat going insane. I mean, I'm pretty sure they would have stopped the timer before he went super low. He was at 40 seconds, actually, wow. I think sometimes the timer goes down to 60 if you disconnect. I'm not really sure how that works on Smokers. Don't play there all the time. Like, play there for friendlies and stuff. With friends. We wait for a game sometimes. I did disconnect again, but yeah, like I said, this has Ice Beam and picks off the Lannis. It does get a special attack boost. And now the Majuna can potentially win. As a Z-Focus Blast is gonna blow this Heatran away. Yeah, I think he just turned it around. Yeah, I don't think he should have switched out. Switching out the Greninja was a potential choke. Like, if he hit the Hydro Pump on the Majuna, even if it doesn't kill, it puts it in Water Shuriken range. Oh my god, that sucks so bad. I feel so bad for my man BTB. Because he was carrying the team, he was building teams for them. They won the RS game where he built a team, he won his game. Yeah, he had to Hydro Pump the Majuna to bring it in Water Shuriken range. Now it's over. I mean, I can completely understand that you don't want to miss, but like, damn, this took it better. He could have just hard switched into his own Majuna. He could have just hard switched into his own Majuna. If he didn't want to risk missing Hydro Pump, he could have just gone into his own Majuna and would have been able to probably put this into range from Water Shuriken with the HP Fire. I will run the calc for you guys really quick. But yeah, I think Hydro Pump still was the... Like, if Hydro Pump hit, it was definitely a win. But there might have been, like... The other play that is going for... What's it called, man? I can't think clear. Which is going hard Majuna. Should also work out, but... Not 100% sure, because... The Majuna would get 2-hit KO'd with a Z-Focus Blast into... I actually might die to Z-Focus Blast. So I'm gonna calc this first. How much Majuna does versus Majuna with a Z-Focus Blast. Just to find out if it would have killed. And afterwards we will kill how much Water Shuriken does. Oh, your Assault Blast. Okay, that's Aura Sphere. We will put Focus Blast. And Z. Z-Focus Blast does 33 to 39, what? There's no way it does that little. That does absolutely nothing, what? So I think he could have just gone to Majuna. He should have been able to pull it out that way. But yeah, let's say if he went for Hydro Pump, which is also what I was thought first was the better play. Hydro Pump does 89 to 105, so... Basically would have blown his Majuna out the window after Starfrog. It might have OKO'd it. Like, the chance increases after Rocks to OKO. It does 37% chance to OKO, and after Rocks is even higher. 60% chance to OKO. So it's 80% chance that you hit and another 60% chance. But that doesn't even matter if he OKOs it. Like, even if he doesn't OKO it, like, he switches out, he comes back, he clicks Water Shuriken. And the opposing Greninja, like, he still had his Majuna in the back then. Like, if you go off Hydro Pump hitting, that was definitely the best play, but Hydro Pump can miss. But I'm not sure if the other play can work out yet, but I will calc how much Water Shuriken does. From the Ash Greninja, it does 50 to 59, good lord. Did he have his Ash Form yet, by the way? Yeah, he did have his Ash Form. So yeah, he could have gone hard into Majuna. If he didn't want to risk the Hydro Pump. Then he goes for HP Fire, gets damage on this to kill, and then he sacks his Majuna, like he will get 2-hit KO'd probably. He might not even get 2-hit KO'd. Yeah, then he goes for Water Shuriken. Picks up the Majuna, then the opposing Greninja comes in and it's at 76. And it has to lock itself into something that can... Which would probably be Hydro Pump. But I think there would still be an out for Obi if he... Like that way. Like Obi can still win with his own Greninja if he plays that way. But it's a bit... it hurts my brain, I don't want to go too much into detail. Like, let me try to explain to you guys. If he goes... So I was basically just replaying to see how much from his team was still alive. So yeah, he didn't have the Latios and he didn't have the Bulu alive. So that is what is important. He didn't have the Latios and the Bulu, so the opposing Greninja from Obi could have been potentially really scary. If he played it that way, he goes into Majuna and beats this Majuna down into range from Water Shuriken. Like his only genie would have been either super low or dead, so Greninja could have picked it off and gotten the Ash form, and then he could have gotten reverse swept by Ash Greninja. So yeah, I don't think that. I still think that Hydroplume was the better play. Like this is just how I see it. Let me know what you guys think. I think Hydroplume was the play. Like I understand you don't want to miss, but at that point you just had to. That was overall your best play, I feel, because it gives you like a 80% chance basically to win the game. And the other way, it's just way too risky. And like definitely, if you switch out, it's definitely not into Landorus. Yeah. If you switch out, it's probably Midjourney. Like I don't really see what else you could have switched out into. And then weakness and water shuriken range, like I said. But yeah, this is gonna be super bad. My man BTB is gonna be at the. He's gonna be so down now. Yeah, they're running Kalyx there too. Okay, so they're saying he had 100% win with accurate moves. I mean, maybe he had 100%, but that's just what I was talking about. Going Midjourney, HP Fire, weakness for Water Shuriken. Okay, yeah, so I would have to calc how much opposing. How much takes opposing, does opposing Greninja take? Yeah, we have to calc this a little bit more. Just to make sure that he maybe had a 100% win. So opposing Greninja takes 43 to 51 from Water Shuriken. Good lord! Yeah, never mind then. I didn't know that it takes that much. And his Greninja was at how much percentage when it when all that happened? Like I just have to know how much percentage his Greninja was at to see if it can live another Hydro Pump, because then he had a 100% guaranteed win. That's just what I want to figure out here. His Greninja was at full. Was it at full? Oh my god, his Greninja was at full, so he had a guaranteed win. Oh, so he did have a guaranteed win with accurate moves, guys. Okay, I just wanted to make sure. Yeah, the Smokeless chat said it, but I wanted to just calc it out. So he goes out into Midjourney, he weakens this for Water Shuriken, like I said, and then he just wins, because Water Shuriken from this Greninja and with 3 hits to it KOs the opposing Greninja, and the opposing Greninja is not in Ash form yet, so the opposing Greninja can only do with the Choice Specs Hydro Pump, which is like the hardest hitting move that it would have to hit opposing Greninja. I assume it can only do like 50. The Greninja was at full, so it was outside of, yeah, 53 to 62. So yeah, he had a 100% guaranteed win. I forgot that the Greninja was at full. So yeah, that sucks a lot for Team India. Thank you guys for watching. I will update this. I will show you here the thread real quick, just to see if they made the win post already. He is saying here Obi-Wan. Go Obi-Wan. What else? They're in the lead and still managed to lose starter pack. Okay, this is not, like, I wouldn't make jokes about this. This is gonna be pain. Oh man, everyone posting this. Good lord. Feels bad. What are these memes? What the fuck are these memes? You guys can read it for yourself. Oh my god. So he said, I want an enable, but I was a Blimex GG dude. Thanks a ton to John and Jama for helping with the nerves and everyone else who cheered me on. Love you all. This series was pretty nonsense on both sides with a bunch of chokes and misplays, but fortunately Metro was given the opportunity to advance. Let's step it up for round 1, guys. Okay. See, I'm gonna be pretty hyped for when round 1 goes up. And I'll be recording a lot of those games for sure. But yeah, I'm just gonna have to calm down a little bit. Because my man BTB was in Team India and I wanted them to make it. And because he was helping, I think he built this team. And yeah. US Metro moves on to World Cup. It's still fine. Like, it's not that I'm fine with them moving on too. But it's just sad because my man is out. And I mean, Cedric is on Metro and I know him too. He's a sub there. So, and also, I don't know Obi much, but I think I have used his teams before. So he's I know him a little bit from the Facebook group. I've talked to him a little bit, but not really much. But yeah, he's cool too. So like I'm happy for them, but except for the others, that's just how it is sometimes. And yeah, peace out, guys. what a sad ending, man. Dokush signing out.